Memory serves, you were supposed to be talking.
I talk.
You talked.
No, I didn't talk. I talked. Talking.
Whee! We're in Disney. Oh, Splash Mountain sucks.
I'm watching the water level, because I hate water levels in, like, everything it is that I do.
Really?
Yes! They all suck! You know what my first introduction to a water level was?
Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
No, Dark Link! Like, do you think I had a great time with Dark Link?
No.
I was 8. Not prepared to face that kind of calamity that is me.
That was PTSD, that's for damn sure.
I was fucking, like, I had to be mentally prepared to fight myself. And at that point in time, I thought I was the best gamer ever. Like, I'm not mentally prepared to fight me, the best ever. I was not the best ever.
Never mind.
Oh, I can breathe again. Was this like the first game that they introduced like drowning?
I don't know.
Go to the thing. Go through the swirl. Jump. Yeah. Get the blue spheres.
You're gonna see how badly I suck at these. Oh, fuck.
Oh, you do suck at these.
I know, babe. God.
Well, at least you made it through a line. Speaking of lines, I wish I had a bunch of Oreos right now. I would do a line of Oreos.
Oh, my God, yes. Oh, fuck off. Yeah, I'd do some Oreos, like, through my nose.
Crunch them up, dice them up with, like, a razor blade, and then move on.
Yeah. It's like, why even take the Viking boat? Just do that. Oh, and I just get bitch slapped by some Invisihand.
Whee! Make water, and then float in bubble. I mean, realistically, how much air is in these bubbles? Like...
100%.
Yeah, but from like what ratio to start with? See? Make water. Float and bubble.
Help! Ma! I'm trapped!
Help! Help!
I tell you, help!
Help! I think Charlotte would appreciate that.
You think Charlotte watches our videos?
Well, I just got a notification that she recently liked our channel.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Or at least on Facebook. So she
Thank you, Charlotte.
Us. Yeah, so she's probably watching her, so
we appreciate your support, and we miss you. Please come back to us.
Totes miss. Especially on my part, probably. You're gonna get crushed.
Oh, fuck.
Man, I'm trying to help. Like, I'm trying to be moral support.
Not in competition with Tim, but I miss you too.
You're totally in competition with me. Well, I miss you more, like 6 to 8% more.
6 to 8%.
I ran the percentages once.
You miss like a pussy.
You could miss her harder. It's like, could I though? All right, story time. Did I tell you about the time that my grandfather got his buddy into a bar fight? So he's at a bar, him and his buddy are drinking, and from what I understand, like,
okay, your grandfather is still alive?
Yeah, he's still alive, not on Facebook or anything like that.
He's totally on the book of faces.
What's that?
He's totally on the book of faces.
Maybe. He's not my friend, though.
Oh. Not my friend.
Anyways.
Hey, Tim, poke your grandfather.
So, like, this story's been passed down to me, and I've got a couple that correlate with him, too. You gonna die because you're running out of air.
I'm
or is that
bubble.
Tails? Oh, Tails is dying. That's fine. I'm sure he's fine. See? Look. There he is. Anyway, there's a couple stories that go along with it. So I guess a little bit of backstory. Like, my grandfather is a cop. Been a cop for ages, and then, like, got, like, bedridden, from, like, an accident way back in the day. In any case, so I've heard a lot of stories, like, secondhand as to, like, the shit that it is that he's had to deal with and whatnot. And one of them is this, one of the two stories that I'll tell you, like, now. So, the first one is probably my favorite, and it's the time that he got into a bar fight. Keep in mind, through all of these stories, he's still a cop. So, he's at a bar drinking with his buddy, and they're having a great time, and they're just knocking him back like nobody's business. And his buddy says, keep in mind, like, my grandfather is our age at that time.
Like early 30s.
Like, yeah, like late 20s, early 30s type. And I think he's in his 70s now, or something like that. So it was quite a while ago where bar fights were like, okay.
Yeah, and cigarette sandwiches were a thing.
Yeah, cigarette sandwiches and, you know, whatever.
Wife beaters weren't ironic.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, so they're drinking, they're having a great time at this bar or whatever, and his buddy looks over at him and says, you know what I've never done? And my grandfather's like, what's that? And he's like, you know, I've never been in a bar fight, and I've always wanted to be in a bar fight. And he's like, you're kidding me. And he's like, no.
Wait, so your grandfather said you're kidding, he's the one that says you're kidding me?
Yeah, yeah, okay. He's like, you're kidding me, you've never been in a bar fight? And he's like, no. And he's like, I have a great time, don't get me wrong, but I've never, you know, been in a bar fight. He's like, huh, all right. And he's like, lean back.
What?
My buddy's like, or not my buddy, his buddy's like, what? He's like, lean back for a second. He's like, okay. Keep in mind, they're sitting at the bar, at it. Not like at a booth, at the bar.
Okay.
His buddy leans back from his drink. My grandfather punches past him and punches the guy sitting right to his right in the face while he's not looking. Just right in his face. Turns, goes back to his drink, acts like he's talking to the bartender. The dude gets up and is like, the fuck's your problem? Punches his buddy in the face. Bar fight starts. It's fucking great. Fucking God. Great. From what I hear, the ending of that is like, the ending of that is like, at that point, like, people obviously get involved because it's a bar fight now. But they start, like, turning their sights to my grandfather, and he pulls out his wallet and pulls out his fucking badge. He goes, I'm a cop, you don't want to do that, because he didn't want to be in a bar fight.
Just, like, completely opts out of this thing.
Yeah, he's started. Like, I don't want to be a part of this, it's stupid.
I'm stupid. Yeah, this is stupid, you're all stupid.
And so, like, immediately at that point, they realize there's a cop in the bar, and they stop their bar fight. Oh, I always thought that the ending was my favorite. Was just like, I don't want to be here. This is stupid.
Oh. Oh, fuck!
You're getting crushed.
That was a fantastic.
So I got another one. Unfortunately,
oh really?
Yeah, these are the only two stories I really remember of my my grandfather in terms of like him being a cop and whatnot. The yeah. other one involves him doing pulling somebody over, like a routine stop kind of thing. Well, I guess not routine stop, but anyway. So he's out. Nothing happened. Like nothing's been happening this evening. He sees somebody who's like. Who's like swerving a little bit, so he's just like, yeah, alright, I'll question the guy or whatever. So he pulls the guy over, and pulls the guy over, walks up there, and he's just like, license and registration. And the guy's rolling down his window, he's like, what? And he's like, license and registration. And he's like, sorry, Ossifer, I didn't get that far in school. And he's just like, what did you say? And he's like, I didn't get that far in school. He's like, huh. And so, at this point, my grandfather's laughing, because that's probably the funniest thing he's ever heard, being a cop.
Yeah.
So he's like, all right, sir, I'm gonna need you to step out of the car. And he's just like, the guy is like, all right. Obviously drunk at this point. I'm sure everybody put that together. Given the fact that his first words were Ossifer.
Yeah.
And he's like, so he gets him out. He's like, all right, I'm gonna... explaining, you know, rights or whatever else. He's just like, I'm gonna have you, do a field sobriety test. And he's like, and the guy's like, okay. He's like, all right, so I'm gonna ask you to touch your nose, walk in a straight line, blah, 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 you know, the whole nine yards. The good dude is belligerently drunk at this point.
Yeah.
Like, and it, at this point, everything that my grandfather's doing is just funny. Like, and so right at the end of it, he asked him, and he's like, all right, I've got one more question for you before I, it's like before we finish this process. He's like, was Mickey Mouse a cat or a dog? Guy's like, huh? He's like, was Mickey Mouse a cat or a dog? And he's like, sorry, Ossifer, I really, really didn't get this far in school. I'm really sorry. And he's like, it's okay, son, get in the truck.
Like the squad vehicle?
Like the squad vehicle. Yeah. Like.
Oh, it's fantastic. Was Mickey Mouse a dog or a cat?
It's in the title!
I know, that was rhetorical.
Like, that was always my thing. Every time, like, I heard that story, I'm like, it's in the fucking title! Like anybody who's drunk could have put it together. Like, and the dude must have really been out there. Gotta go fast.
Please, Lord, let me get out of this game.
I wish I had more stories, because he was, he's a cop, like, way back when there was a lot of shit that was, like, okay. Like, in terms of, like, you can get in a bar fight and not be bothered, you know what I mean? Where you just let people go, like, oh, don't do it again. Like,
yeah.
Don't punch your neighbor. Or do, like, it's your choice.